Yes, sir, join.
Okay, good to know. Very good morning to one and all. I'm Saurav Sandilya. I'm in charge of academics and strategy at My Rehab Academy. Today, we are here to learn about overview of cancer rehabilitation. But before starting that, I would like to get you know something about My Rehab Academy. As you all know about My Rehab Academy, is a platform which connects you the best of the instructors across the globe and brings you the best for your upgradation, for your knowledge and expertise, wherever you are. We have successfully enrolled more than 2,000 members till now. And these members are, I can tell you, these are having a lot of opportunity, as lot of access to learn a lot of things, which is available at My Rehab Academy. My Rehab Academy is an award-winning organization. As you all know about it, that we have got award, especially in the rehabilitation education sector. And today, in this vibrant morning, we have joined here to learn about overview of cancer rehabilitation. As we realized that as we are doing a lot of courses and making people to learn about a lot of techniques, new techniques, in fact, and the new research and development in our field. Along with this, we started a new thing so that we can bring people from learning to earning. I mean to say, we are coming up, in fact, we have already come up with a platform called My Rehab Care, which will allow you to get enrolled, and you can find all A to Z medical services available at our platform. You have to have just 2 to 3 clicks and services will be available to you. So that as a part of client I'm talking to. You as a physio can get enrolled wherever you are there in the country. And then as we are coming up the phase wise with every city, so you will have access to your patients, your all data will be there in your digital way. So it's very well designed digital accessible platform. More than that, you can just search on myrehabcare.in or you can message to 9008533336. And more than that, I can tell you this is one of the best technology we have devised, where the GPS enabled thing will be done. So it's totally transparent, as well as it is totally, I can say you that it's a focused one. So you will not have any issues in terms of data, as well as in terms of your any sort of problem solving and techniques or anything. So, and we are there 24 hours to help you. You can download our app from the Play Store as well as from the App Store, whichever phone you are using. Now coming to the today's event overview of cancer rehabilitation is by Dr. Shailendra Mehta. Sir's profile is quite long and it is acknowledged across the globe that sir is one of the wonderful teacher and wonderful lymphedema management therapist. Sir is professor in physiotherapy, cancer rehabilitation and preventive oncology practice physiotherapist. Sir is certified lymphedema management physiotherapist. He's trained by Tata Memorial Hospital, Bombay and Lymphedema Training Academy, UK. For lymphedema management. Sir is founder and secretary at Spurs Health Education, Cancer Rehabilitation and Social Welfare Foundation. Sir is director at Spurs Physical and Onco Rehabilitation Center, Udaipur, Rajasthan. So myself, on behalf of my whole core team, we welcome you, sir, Dr. Shailendra Mehta, for today's event. Sir is connected, I guess. My warm welcome to sir. Sir, are you able to hear me?
Please unmute.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Well, can hear.
Dr. Saurav, so good morning all the participants who have joined me today here for cancer rehabilitation. As you all know, that the cancer is the word enough to fettle anybody. And first of all, I extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Saurav, who has provided me opportunity to interact with a lot of participants regarding cancer rehabilitation. So time to time, they are organizing such type of free workshops to interact regarding cancer rehabilitation with all the participants. So it's a good initiative by My Rehab Academy. to organize such type of program to discuss a common platform for all the rehabilitation program HBR physios. So as you all know about the cancer, it's word enough to fatal anybody. That a lot of ideas came in patient mind initially after hearing the word cancer only. Why it happens to me only, I have done something wrong, God has punished me for something, lot of things are there. Okay, it's a very difficult process for any patient to go start from the diagnosis after that surgery, because 90% cases the patient needs surgery only, after that chemo, radio and all the complication will come, and every complication patient has to sort out by a lot of clinical care teams and medical professionals. So it's a very difficult process for all the patients. So nowadays you can see a lot of opportunities there in field of cancer rehabilitation, because since starting from the diagnosis, it's a long process. It's not a 1 week, 1 month or 1 year process. Patient who has to go for the treatment for 2 years also, 3 years also, after that chances of recurrence is there, lifelong chances of recurrence is there. So it's a good field for the rehabilitation for all the physios and other medical professions. You can go with the cancer rehabilitation field. Lot of opportunities there. You can involve yourself in the cancer rehabilitation or any oncology rehabilitation. So today we'll discuss a little bit regarding the cancer rehabilitation only. Just give me time. I will share my screen. Just a minute. Okay. Okay, Dr. Saurabh, can you see it?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Then everybody knows about cancer. What is cancer? You know? Yes? You can tell in a simple way. Rapid and uncontrollable development and production of cells. Very simple definition. Wherever the uncontrolled growth is there, development is there, definitely it is the cancer. Okay? So, you know normal cell also, cancer cell also. Whenever any normal cell will get any external stimulus by any chemical, physical, whatever reason is there, definitely it will convert in the abnormal cell. You can see cancer cells here. You cannot tell the cancer is affecting only the females, males, Africans, Indians, young children, young adults or elder. Everybody can suffer from cancer. Okay, only the thing is there, the incidence is increasing with the age. So what is the special characteristics of the cancer? Multiplies rapidly surrounding the destroyed tumor. Always whenever the malignant tumor is there, multiplies rapidly and surrounding distance and other tissues. Spread to distant parts of the body. It is the typical nature of any cancerous cell or cancer. Why does cancer occur? Lot of reasons are there. External factor, internal factor, hormonal factor, lot of factors are there. Just see ultraviolet radiation, tobacco, dyes, chemicals, you know, normal cell cycle also. How you will define the cancer? Cancer is not a single disease, but rather than a great variety of this malignant tumor that are formed by the same basic process because of the uncontrolled growth. Very simple phenomena. It is the very common and very challengeable problem in present scenario for the clinical medicine, because everywhere cancer is there. It is a global problem. You cannot tell only the region wide or specific. It is a global problem. So it's a very challenging field in present scenario. Cancer may affect people at all the ages. Even features, but risk for the more common with the age. Again, I'm telling you, the risk is increasing with the age, otherwise you will affect all the pupils. Early diagnosis and early treatment are vital, and identification of the person with the increased risk. That is the main thing. That's why we have just incorporated this document, or just we want to engage ourselves in the early diagnosis and early treatment phase, just to prevent the patient from developing second stage of the carcinomas. Okay, just see here. What are the clinical features always related with the sites only? If the brain is involved, then headache, seizures, vertigo, respiratory system means cough, hemoptysis, dyspnea, lymph nodes means lymphadenopathy and all these things, liver means jaundice, hepatomegaly, skeletal system means pain, fractures, spinal cord compression and other neurological and muscular complications are there. Okay. What are the common reasons? Again, external and internal factor. Internal always hormonal factor, immune conditions and inherited mutations. External reasons means chemical, radiation, viruses and your lifestyle. That is your habits and lifestyle. Okay, some of the theories also supporting the development of the cancer, like carcinogenous theory, oncogenous theory, lot of theories are there. Who are more at the risk of cancer? So lifetime risk is there, because again and again I am telling you, all everybody can suffer from the cancer. You cannot tell only the children, young adults, elderly, males, females, Indians, Europeans, you nothing like that. Everybody can suffer. Only the thing is there, risk is always increasing with the age. Then relative risk is also there. People those are working in some relative factor, associated factor, like the people are working in the, they are residing in the industrial areas, working in the some chemical factory. They are more the women after the age of the 45 to 50 years. It's a very common age for the development of any type of the cancer, like breast cancer and uterine or ovarian cancer for the females. So some of the people are at relative risk. Okay, like the European countries are, people are more riskful for development of any type of the skin cancer. Those are more in exposure of the harmful ultraviolet radiation. So a lot of relative factors are there. Then your habits and your lifestyle. Smoking, 30% of all the cancer deaths because of the smoking only. And out of that, 87% because of the lung cancer only. Just see the incident. Then obesity, 50% more common to develop any type of cancer in the obese people as in normal people. So some of the relative risk and risk factors are there. Otherwise, anybody can suffer from the cancer. Then etiology again, multifactorial, medical, environmental, lifestyle, and your habits. Then genetic factors also. Some of the theories also supporting. Okay. Just see the chemicals. What are the chemicals responsible for development of alcohol, explosive wooden dust, rubber, plastic, dyes, tar, butamine, and factors, alkali agent, and tobacco. These are the common chemicals responsible. Then smoking, again, I am telling you, it's a very common habit for development of any type of lung cancer. Just see 25 to 40% smokers die in their middle age only, 1950s only. Just see, since last 70 years, 9 out of 10 lung cancers because of the smoking habit only. Okay, it's a very common cause for the development of any type of the lung cancer, your smoking habit. Again, smoking and alcoholism. Again, industrial pollution also one of the, because some of the people are residing in industrial areas only. So it is also very common reason for the development of any physical agents also. Ultraviolet radiation, then sunlight. Sometimes you will get the ultraviolet radiation from the, during the treatment also. During some of the cancer treatment also, there will be chance for development of any type of cancer. Obesity. 50% more chances for development of any type of cancer as compared to normal people. Why the obesity will develop? Because of the high calorie dense diet, rich in the fat, refined carbohydrates, animal proteins, low physical activity. Whenever the obesity will come, definitely diabetes, cardiovascular conditions, and hypertension will also come. So it is also one of the common factor for. Then four most common factor for development of the cancer, any type of cancer, age. Again, I am telling you, the risk is increasing with the age. First thing, then occupation, your occupation, what you are doing. It is also very common factor for development of any type of the cancer. Then because some of the people are working in some chemical industries, some coal mines, some pharma, so a lot of things are there. So occupation also one of the most common reason for development of any type of cancer. Then ethnicity, why? Because one best example is the prostate cancer. It is more common in the African Americans as compared to other people. So your racial, your ethnicity also one of the reason for the development of any type of the cancer. Then deprivation. Definitely some of the children are at the risk of the development of any malnutrition symptoms or malnutrition disease. So they are more prone for development of, so it is also one of the common reasons. So these are the four common factors for development of. No, how we divide the cancer tumors? Two types, benign and malignant. Everybody knows what do you mean by benign? Self-limiting growth, do not invade or metastasize in their nature. Malignant is always excessive growth, invasive in their nature. Okay. Again, you can differentiate, just see the picture, how you will differentiate then. Well differential, always benign, slow growth rate, expansive, usually harmless. The uterine polyp is the best example for the benign tumor, whereas the malignant always anaplastic, rapid, infiltrative in their nature, expansive, can spread to distant metastasis also there, and always harmful for our body. So that is the main difference between the benign and malignant. Again, one more classification is there regarding the cancers: carcinomas, sarcomas, lymphomas, and leukemia. You know, carcinomas, tumors rising from the connective tissue. It can be anywhere in our body. Sarcomas are the generally tumors rising from the soft tissues, tendons, ligaments, muscles. Lymphomas are tumors rising from the lymphatic system. Leukemias are, leukemia is also blood cancer and all these things. Okay. Common types of cancer, when we'll discuss about the common type of cancer, some of the common type of cancer in present world, the first one is the lung cancer. What is the most common reason? Just only I told you your habits only, smoking habits. Okay, just see the incidence here in 2006, as per the American Cancer Society, around 1,74,470 people suffering from a new diagnosis and died because of the lung cancer only. Just see incidence in 1987 only. What is the common symptom for the lung cancer? Persistent cough, blood streak, sputum, chest pain. All these symptoms will come. Treatment, again, surgery, chemo and radio. Then how you can prevent? By your habit only. Avoid smoking and environmental tobacco, smoke and pollution. So definitely you can prevent yourself from development of any type. So again, in India and our country, where we are lacking, every time I am telling, we are lacking here in the screening program for all the types. So there are most of the cases diagnosed here in the secondary stage only. So survival rate is also less as compared to other developed countries. There, most of the cases they will diagnose in the primary stage only. So their survival rate around 60%, here 30% only. Why? Because we are lacking in the screening program. Again, first time in our country, 10 years study after launch in the 2002, that is also in some of the metro cities, new spiral CT scan for the lung cancer. But here we are lacking in the screening. Okay, that's why just see the picture of the normal lung and cancerous lung. Second one, breast cancer, very common cancer. 1 out of 8 women, there are chances to develop in their lifetime. So incidence again, it's increasing with the age, because again and again, I'm telling for the females, there are more chances after the 40 to 45 years, menopausal hormonal changes here, for development of any type of the cancer, either breast cancer, uterine, ovarian cancer. Just see the incidence here. Less than 40 years, 1 out of 227 women, 40 to 60, 1 out of 25, 60 to 81 out of 15. So incidence is always increasing with the age only. How you can diagnose for the breast cancer? Mammogram, regular breast examination, self-examination. So a lot of things you have to apply for the diagnosis of the symptoms. Abnormal growth in the breast tissue, skin changes, thickening of pimpling, skin irritation, sometimes the blood discharge, lot of things are there. Okay, risk factors, again, family history, obesity, low physical activity, menstrual abnormal history, more use of the contraceptive device, a lot of things regarding that also. Treatment, again, surgery also, lumpectomy, sometime mastectomy, okay, then chemo and radio, then rehabilitation. And how you can prevent? By changing your lifestyle, especially after the age of the 45 to 50 years or for all the women. Okay, prevention, exercise is always good prevention for them. Again, here we are lacking in the screening. In other developed countries, after the age of the 40 years, every year a woman has to go for the mammogram. Yearly clinical breast examination should be compulsory. So here we don't have this type of the screening facilities. That's why most of the cases diagnosed in the secondary stage only. Next, colorectal cancer. So that is also third of most common cancer in the world for all the males and females. Just see a risk factor again, our dietary habits only. History of colon or rectal cancer, sometimes because of the polyps only, diet high in the fat, again, rich in the proteins, animal proteins, all this. So again, here, low fiber content, these are the common factors for development of any type of colon. 90% colorectal cancer we can prevent by our dietary habits only. Okay, again, treatment, surgery, chemo and radio. So how we can prevent, what are the precautions we have to take for the colorectal cancer? Regular exercise, diet should be rich in the fruits and plant origin, and health, we should always concern about weight control also. So these are the things by that we can prevent colorectal cancer. Again, here we are looking in the screening. There in developed countries, yearly FOBT examination, fecal occult blood test is compulsory for just screening of the older type of the colorectal cancer. Then flexible sigmoidoscopy in each 5 years. Okay, colonoscopy in each 10 years, especially after the age of the 40 years. So like that, they can prevent from development of the secondary stage. They can diagnose in initial stage only. Okay, here again, we are lacking. Prostate cancer, just only I told you, very common cancer for the Americans, African Americans. Just see incidence in 2006, around 2,34,000 new cases diagnosed with the prostate cancer only, even in USA only. 1 in 3 men will be diagnosed in their lifetime. It's a very common cancer for the Americans. Okay, symptom again, non-specific, difficulty in passing urine and all these things. You know, prostate, it's a muscular walnut-shaped gland surrounding the outer part of the urethra. It's a main function to produce the same either fluid. So risk factor again, your races here, see, nationality and races, especially in the case of the prostate cancer. It is also one of the risk factors. Prevention, diet should be rich in the leucopins and vitamin E. So by that, you can prevent the development of the prostate cancer. Again, we are lacking in the screening. Just see again, after the age of the 50 years, every year the people, those are more risk for the development of prostate cancer, they have to go for the PSA antigen examination yearly. Okay, mainly the African Americans, they are more at the risk for development of this type of cancer. Again, the skin cancer, because of the harmful ultraviolet radiations, the European countries, people are more at the risk for development of any type of the skin cancer. So again, prevention. Limited exposure of the harmful ultraviolet radiation, drink more fruits and plenty of water we have to take, then cool compression we have to apply to the skin, we have to moisturize the skin whenever we'll go out in the sunlight, lot of things that we can do for the prevention also. Then how we'll diagnose the skin cancer patient? By ABCD rule. A means asymmetry, B means border irregularity, C means color variability, diameter is more than 6 mm, definitely be considered as the some carcinomas patches only. So you can easily differentiate between normal and carcinomas. The testicular cancer is very common cancer for the young age, especially the people who suffer between 15 to 35 years only. Okay, so here again, what you can do for the awareness of the testicular cancer, self-examination is the best way. Okay, you should create awareness among the young adults just to self-examine their testes in the particular age only. Okay, that is the best way. Next, ovarian cancer and uterine cancer, very common cancer for all the females. Just see instance again, around 50,000 women in 2006 newly diagnosed with this type of cancer, both the types of cancer. enlargement of the abdomen is the very common feature. Risk factor again, family history, age, childbearing age, or cancer history, then fertility, drugs, these are the common risk factors. So your diet should be rich in the vegetables, physical activity should be continued, especially after the age of the 45 to 50 years. Then exercise, sleep and stress, anxiety management, these are the common ways to prevent from all this type of cancer. Next one again, endometrial and uterine cancer, just only I told you. Pap smear examination is the best examination for diagnosis. Then associated factor again, endometrial cancer, age, endometrial hyperplasia, overweight, obesity, all these things, your blood pressure. And here again, we are lacking in each 3 years after the age of the 45 or 40 years, woman has to go for the regular pap smear examination. But here again, we are lacking for the screening. So most of the cases diagnosed in the what are the common complications and the clinical feature of all the type of cancer? Acute, always nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, excavation, and hypersensitivity reactions. Then immediate alopecia, febrile neutropenia, pulmonary toxicity, neurological, and later phase, there are chances for the cardiac and reproductive also. And some of the features related with the your involvement of the system also. These are the common clinical features. So what are the common complications? First one is the pain. Definitely, cancer-related pain, very common problem for all the cancer patients before the treatment also, during the surgery, and after the surgery, during the rehabilitation also. Pain can be caused by cancer or by cancer treatment also, sometimes because of the radio chemo also. It's a very painful process. So definitely you have to manage the cancer-related pain also. Again, fatigue. Fatigue is people with cancer has many causes, but it can often be managed easily. We can manage as a physio, as a rehabilitation therapist, fatigue also. Then difficulty in breathing, very common complication. Then nausea, certain cancer treatment causes nausea during the surgery also, before surgery, after the surgery also, so many patients used to feel the nausea also. So it's very easily manageable by the drugs. Then diarrhea and constipation also, because of involvement of bowel and bladder, very common. Then sometimes weight loss also, because cancer steals food from normal cells only, and that depends from the normal nutrition. So it's very common symptom, weight loss also. So definitely we have to manage, and medical profession also has to manage the weight loss also. Then chemical changes in our body, very common symptom because of the excessive thrust, frequent urination, constipation and confusion. Definitely it will come. Then brain and nervous system involvement, because sometimes because of the compression from the surrounding tissue, sometimes because of the involvement of the neural part of nervous system structures. Then unusual immune reactions also, sometimes paraneoplastic syndrome also will develop. Why? Because in some cases body's immune system may react to the presence of the cancer by attacking healthy cells also. So these also one of the common complications for. Then how you will diagnose any cancer cases? So a lot of diagnostic procedures are there: biopsy, endoscopy, blood test, bone marrow aspiration, pap smear examination, visual and tactile observation, then imaging techniques like CT scan, MRI, ultrasound, genetic analysis also. These are the common diagnostic procedure for any type of the cancer. Then treatment, what are the common treatment available in present scenario for any type of cancer? Surgeries, chemo, radio, target therapies, immunotherapies, hyperthermia, cell transplant also one of the common latest procedure. Photodynamic therapy also, lasers also, bone marrow transfusion, blood transfusion. These are the common treatment protocol for all the types of the cancers. Then as a physio, as a rehabilitation therapist, what is your role in any type of the cancer? So definitely we have the four types of role in rehabilitation phase. First one is the restorative care, supportive care, palliative care, and preventive care, preventive rehabilitation, definitely. Restorative care means, you know, we have to restore again the all the functions in the patient. Support, we have to provide the support also, all the types of physical support, psychological support, all the types of the support, lifestyle support, vocational support, all the types of support we have to provide to the cancer patient. Then palliative, we are the member of the palliative care team. You know what is the palliative care? Specialized care for the specialized cancer patient. So we are also the member of the palliative care team. So definitely our role as a rehabilitation therapist, as a physiotherapist for the palliative care also. Then prevention, because lifetime recurrence chances is there. So definitely we have to concern about the prevention also. Prevention before development also, and recurrence also, both we have to prevent. Okay, so our role definitely four types only: restorative, supportive, palliative, and preventive. So what are the common problem for any type of the cancer patient in rehabilitation phase? Lymphedema, cancer related pain, cancer related fatigueness, genitourinary complication, peripheral neurological deconditioning. These are the common complications. Then sometimes the neuropathy is because of the involvement of the some of the nervous system. Plexophily is involvement of the again nervous part only. The myopathy is chemotherapy, radiotherapy induced side effects. Then edema, fatigue, pain, immobility, generalized deconditioning, bone destruction, depression, psychological, another factor, systemic specific problem because of the involvement of the specific system where the cancer is mainly occur. So these are the common complication for any type of the cancer patient. Again, fatigueness, cancer pain, stiffness, wound scar, lymphedema, one of the most common because of the involvement of the lymphatic system or some of the part of the lymphatic system. So these are the common problems for any cancer patient. Whenever you will do the practice in cancer rehabilitation field, definitely these type of the patient will come with all these problems only. Then how you can manage the fatigueness? Best way to manage the fatigueness, aerobic exercise. Always start in all the rehabilitation phase for all the cancer patient with aerobic exercise only. Then bed rest, energy conservation technique, diversional techniques just to prevent the energy level and just to prevent the fatigueness of the patient. Then rest, sleep pattern and anxiety management, stress management and nutritional management. These are the best way to manage the any fatigueness in any cancer patient. So like that you can manage. Then how do you can manage the pain? So range of motion exercises, or you have to maintain or increase the range of motion. You have to relieve the pain, restore it, muscle functions, strength. Then physical modalities also, sometimes you can use the low frequency modalities in some cases like TENS and interferential therapy. Electric stimulation also sometimes you can use. Heat modalities also you can use for the pain relief in some. Then passive treatment also, it's very good for the pain management. Passive movements and all the passive exercises, heat and cold therapies, TENS also. Then active treatment also, sometimes active exercise and home exercise program. So by these way you can manage the pain in cancer patient. Just see, one of the most common complication is the lymphedema. So easily you can differentiate between normal limb and lymphedema limb. Just see here pictures for the hand and upper limb and lower limb. So lymphedema, you all know, it is the accumulation of the extra fluid in any of the body part, protein rich fluid, always it's a chronic swelling. So lymphedema is also one of the, it's a very common complication for the post surgical cases. Around 49% in one research came in 2001 by Pritikatol, as per that research, around 49% chances are there for development of the lymphedema in the PCRA, based cancer related surgery cases after the surgery. Okay, it may be up to 20 years of the surgery also after the surgery. It's not like the only 1 in 2 years only. There are chances to develop in 20 years also after the surgery. Okay, just see next. What are the common parts of the lymphatic system? Tonsils, thymus, spleen, lymph nodes and bone marrow, all these are the common part of the lymphatic system. How you can define the lymphedema? Accumulation of the protein-rich fluid in excess in any body part that has experienced damage to the lymphatic system. Lymphedema, again, long-term chronic swelling, just only a lot of definitions are there. It is always chronic and progressive. According to research in 49% in cases, 2000 pretty good. There are chances to develop the lymphedema. It is always associated with the psychological and physical morbidities and more. The main problem here, poorly recognized and managed by the any rehabilitation therapist, because referral services we are lacking in our country regarding the lymphedema. Still, we are lacking in the referral services. People are not more aware. The medical professions where the first the patient used to go for the any lymphedema after the surgery, they are not more aware for the referral services. They are here we are lacking. That's why the poorly recognized and managed in initial phase only. So most of the patient used to come in the second and third stage only. It's very difficult to manage by rehabilitation therapist also. It is the sometime it will develop in the one upper limb, lower limb, or sometimes full of the trunk, sometimes full of the body also involved. It is the result of the accumulation of the fluid and other elements in the tissue space due to the imbalance between the interstitial fluid production and transportation. That is the main reason for development of the lymphedema, because of the imbalance between the production and transportation. So definitely some of the part fruit part will remain in your interstitial tissue. That is only the lymphedema. Okay, very simple definition. Just see a picture. Lymphatic filariasis is a very common condition, but it is because of the parasite infection transmitted by the mosquito, especially in the endemic and coastal areas only. Just see here. This is like lymphedema. Later phase lymphedema only will develop. Risk factor always associated with the some of the common conditions. Upper limb common risk factors are the axillary lymph nodes, the dissection because of the involvement of the, some of the part of the lymphatics in the all the breast cancer and all these things. Sometimes scar formation, fibrosis also. Sometimes radiotherapy to the breast and the axillary lymph nodes also. Sometimes because of the clotting formation, seroma, hematoma formation also. Sometimes because of the obesity also. Sometimes because of the hypertension, Tixan therapy also, hormonal therapy. A lot of reasons are there. Sometimes because of the arteriovenous shunting also in all the surgeries. Okay. Same thing for the lower limb also. Surgeries for the inguinal lymph node because they are the part of the lymphatic system. So definitely lymphatic load will increase in the lower limb. Obesity also, varicose vein also. advanced form of the cancer also, sometimes because of the orthopedic region also, sometimes because of poor nutritional status also, sometimes because of thrombophlebitis and phlebitis, all these things also. Sometimes because of the hyperthyroidism also, kidney disease and liver function also. Sometimes because of the immobilization and prolonged bed rest also. A lot of things are there regarding the development of the lymphedema and lower limb also. Lymphedema is mainly two types, primary and secondary. Primary again divided in three categories, congenital, then tarda and precox, okay. So common things for the primary like aplasia, hypoplasia, reduce the lymphatic channels, number of lymphatic channels, sometimes increase the diameter, sometimes decrease the diameter, lot of conditions. Sometimes fibrosis of the inguinal lymph node is also the Kinmore syndrome and all these things. So it's always the primary lymphedema. Secondly, because of the damage of the lymphatic system during the surgery, after the surgery, during the chemo and radio, lot of regions are there. Sometimes during the surgery, just see here, sometimes because of the radio chemo also, sometimes because of the malignant tumor, sometimes because of the lymphovenous edema also, sometimes because of dependency edema also. Okay, a lot of things are there regarding secondary also. So how you will classify the grading of the lymphedema? So lot of classification protocols are there, but very simple here, 0, 1st, 2nd and 3 grades, latent, mild, moderate and severe. So what will happen in the latent phase? No visible changes you can see here. Only the tightness and patient will just loss of little bit sensation only. What happened in grade 1? Swelling in the affected area can change throughout the day. Tissue will hold on the identification, you can press it. Pitting edema is there, okay? So just remember by pitting edema only in grade 1. Grade 2, there is the irreversible edema. Irreversible swelling is there. Fibrosis will start to develop here. And grade 3, severe condition only, definitely. Fluid retention is there, then full of the fibrosis only. Tissue will become the hardened and become very large. Skin changes are permanent. It's not reversible. So like that, you can classify in the 0, 1st, 2nd and 3rd grade for all the lymphedema cases. Where are the chances for development of any type of lymphedema? Everywhere. Breast cancer, melanomas, gynecological, genitourinary, head and neck cancer. There are everywhere chances for development of any type of the lymphedema. Okay. So just remember this thing also. Then fast view to go. You know, in our lymphatic system, so in our body, like arterial and venous system, one of the most common and very important system, the lymphatic system also. So same like the arterial and venous system. What is the main function of the lymphatic system? Just to carry all the lymphatics in the drained fluid. Just to carry all the lymphatics in the venous retention fluid, so it will remove from our body. Okay. So you know, lymph, same like the blood only. So lymph is carried by the lymphatic system only. So what are the contents of the lymph? Protein, water, fatty acids, and white blood cell, microorganism, foreign bodies, all are the parts of the lymphatic system only. So it's a very important system, same like the RTA. Just see here, major trunks and all these things, parts of the lymphatic system. You can easily, another picture for the important organ for the lymphatic system, tonsils, thymus, mucosa, secret lymphatic tissue, spleen, hair patches, and all these things. What are the two main functions of the lymphatic system? Just tell me first thing. Maintain volume and pressure of the extracellular fluid by returning excess water and dissolved substances from the interstitial fluid into the main circulation. That is the first function. Just to maintain the volume of the fluid in the interstitial space. Then second main function is the tissues are the site for colonial production of the immunocompetent. Just to maintain our immunity. These are the two main parts of the lymphatic system. Don't forget. It's a very important system. Just see here. Everywhere you will just find out this type of picture. Red one is the arterial, blue one is the venous, and green one is the lymphatic system. All the three systems are everywhere working simultaneously to maintain the fluid balance and all the immunity of our body. I will show some of the pictures where you will get the picture same like the lymphedema only, but these are the other clinical conditions. Just one by one, differential lipidema, same picture you will get filariasis, then Miller-Rey disease, recurrent cellulitis, lymphovenous granulum, scrofula, then surgery of the prostate, uterus and cervix, then some recurrent and metastatic malignancy condition also, Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin's disease, then reconstruction arterial surgery. Here also you will get the same type of picture, mixed edema, SLE, RA, you know RAO also, then psoriatic arthritis, so everywhere you will get the chronic dermatitis, but it is because of some another reason, retroperitoneal fibrosis, paniculitis, systemic disease, grave disease and all these things, photoconiosis, then liver problems, liver disease, hypoalbuminemia, kidney disorders, nephrotic syndrome, malabsorption syndrome, drug-induced edema also sometimes. So how you will assess the lymphedema cases? Because before starting treatment for the lymphedema, you have to do assessment also. So again, your objective and subjective, two type of assessment procedure is. Objective always, oliometry, infermetry, barometry, bioimpedance, and water displacement meter. Subjective, no, skin condition, vascular assessment, pain assessment, nutritional and psychological assessment for the patient, and mobility and function. Okay, so objective, volumeter, very simple technique, infrared, optical, electronic scanner, calculate the extra volume of the fluid present in the upper limb or lower limb. So it's very simple procedure. You can do at your clinic also. Then tonometry, you have to calculate here how much extra pressure is needed to make indent on the skin. Pressure and time, how much time it will take to come in the normal stage. So it's a very simple device. You can do by your goniometer also at your clinic. So like that also you can check. It's also one of the, then bioimpedance, you have to check the how much time it will take to, because of the, you know, resistance. So how much fluid is, extra fluid is applied, the resistance to pass the current throughout the any body part. So by that procedure, you can rule out the extra time just needed to penetrate the waves through the body part. So how much more resistance is there. So that is also one of the, then water displacement method, very simple method. You can do for the upper limb, lower limb also, small body parts also, full of the body also. Okay. Then some of the medical diagnostic procedure at labs also, like lymphogen scintigraphy, then lymphoscintigraphy by the help of the radioisotope and all the colloid isotopes, how much time they will take to just reach on the proximal lymph nodes. So if they will take more time, definitely there are more extra volume of the fluid is present. Then volumetry also one of the common technique, just only water displacement method also, anthropometric measurement also, you know about BMI and all the limb volume calculator also. You can easily differentiate during the rehabilitation phase also, your treatment phase also, and you, if you want to assess the grading of lymphedema also, then also it's very effective. So you can easily make the mark 5, 10, 15 inches above the joint and below the joint line, and you can do for the upper limb, lower limb, and trunk also. It's also very common assessment procedure for all the lymphedema. Then how you will manage the lymphedema in all the cancer cases? So cryotherapy, then TENS also sometimes you can use for the relieving pain. Then thermal therapy also sometimes you can use for relieving pain. Ultrasound also you can use for relieving pain and healing purposes especially. Then some of the complementary medicine technique that today I will show some of the pictures also, like MLD, manual lymphatic drainage technique. Second one is the MLLB, multi-layer lymphedema bandaging technique. So some of the complementary medicines techniques. No, we are applying as a physio rehabilitative therapist at our clinical setup. It's very effective. MLD also, special type of the massage. It's very effective for all the lymphedema cases. Then MLLB also, multi-layer lymphedema bandaging. Okay. The practical classes I will explain about all these techniques. So what is MLD? It is a special type of massage used in combination with the skin care, compression therapy, and exercise. MLD always a special type of massage, always we will use in combination of the three things: skin care, compression therapy, and exercise. It's very effective for all the lymphedema cases. Then lot of techniques regarding MLD, Bodler, Ludeck, Poldi, Kessler, Smith. So especially I am using here Ludeck technique only. Then what is the common principle for the, we have to clear main junction first, the proximal junction, then we have to go for the distal junction. Again, proximal, distal, proximal, like that we have to apply the, your movement should be superficial and gentle, and right speed and repetition. Just remember these things only while doing MLD. Okay. Then MLLB, it's a very good technique, complementary technique for just removing the lymphedema. Again, it is a key element of the intensive therapy regimen. For some patient, it may affect from part of their transition also. Long-term or palliative management also is needed. Which type of bandages we are using here? Mainly inelastic bandages, remember this thing, because here they are producing high working pressure, low resting pressure. Here we need the high working pressure only, so mainly the inelastic bandages we are using here. Okay, what are the common indication for using the MLD? Large volume of swelling is there in the part, improve limb shape, we want to improve, if we want to improve the limb shape, then enhances the skin condition also, manage symptoms like lymphorrhea and all these things. So it's a very good technique. So pressure always depends on the so many types of factors of the bandage, like tension, extensibility, power and elasticity, stiffness also. And this type of bandages, again, I'm telling here, mainly the inelastic short stretch bandages we are using, where in other rehabilitative phase, for where we want for the immobilization in sports injuries, we are applying the bandage for 1 or 2 days. There we are using the long stretch elastic bandages, but in the MLLB we are using the inelastic bandage. Don't forget here, because here the 60-70% extensibility only there, but high working pressure. Because here we need the high working pressure and low resting pressure. There we need the low working pressure but high resting pressure, because we want to do the bandaging for immobilization, just to give the rest to the part. So that is the main difference with both the bandages. So some of the contraindications regarding the MLLB also, like severe arterial insufficiency, uncontrolled heart failure, DVT cases, severe peripheral neuropathy, diabetes cases, or episodes of cellulitis and all these things. What are the component of the bandaging system? Just I will show you. The component of the bandaging system is like tubular bandage, extra forms, finger bandages, inelastic bandages, all are. Then tape, microports also we are using. So these are the component of the bandaging system. Okay. So what are the common principle while applying the MLLB? Because I told you in MLD, first we have to clear the proximal junction, then only we have to go for the distal junction. Whereas the opposite pattern in the MLLB, we have to start from the distal and we have to go the proximal. Protect the affected area by using the tubular bandage and other soft forms. Then start bandaging distally and go to proximally. Remember this thing. Guide bandage close to the limb. Always just keep the bandage close to the limb in the always apply the uniform pressure only. Always apply additional padding at the uneven surfaces like the popliteal fossa and all these things. Use several layers of the inelastic bandages to achieve the desired pressure. Because if you don't use these several layers, you need the more bandages there. Minimize creases should be there here always. Always assess the security of the bandage by fixing with the microband, core and all other things. Patient should be encouraged to contribute in the development of the bandaging system, because after some days from your clinic, you have to discharge patient for the self-bandaging. So definitely patient should be part of your bandaging system. You should involve the patient also. Another type of the drug treatment also available for the edema relief, and you know the most common, the diuretics and benzopyrin. Breathing exercise, very useful for all the cancer patients. Firstly, breathing exercise, coordinated breathing, deep breathing, huffing, taking diaphragmatic breathing, all are very useful for the cancer patient. Then some of another complementary medicine technique as a physiotherapy, rehabilitation therapy, like the lymphedema band taping. Sometimes we are using the kinesiological taping also for the lymphedema cases. Okay, so what is the main use? How much time duration we needed for the taping? Generally, we will apply the taping for the 5 days in a week. Okay, so very comfortable to wear also, and directly over swollen area we can apply this type of the taping. So it will enhance the lymphedema drainage from the deeper layer. That is the main principle while behind applying the taping. Kinesiological taping gently lifts the upper layers of the skin and creating negative pressure that encourages the removal of excess fluid from the deeper layers. Just remember this thing. Always we will apply the taping in the fan-like pattern only, with narrow fingers of tape crisscrossing the surface of the affected area. So just place like that only. And laser therapy also we can use in some of the cases, mostly the low level laser therapy. Don't go for the high level laser therapy. Remember this thing also. Then hyperbaric oxygen therapy also very effective in some of the cancer cases, because immediately it will improve the oxygen level of the patient. So then skin care, very important part of the all the complementary medicine and the rehabilitation care of the lymphedema cases and the cancer patient. Always wash daily to the skin. Skin fold should be clean, dry. Every day skin inspection you should do on the regular basis. They apply emollients, avoid skin-related product. All these things you have to remember while doing the skin care. What are the another conservative measures for the cancer patient? What is your aim? Improve range of motion, improve strength, improve functional activity of the patient, improve the posture of the patient, decrease pain at the surgical site. You have to decrease the cancer-related pain also, cancer-related fatigue also. You have to manage the edema also. You have to improve the sensation also. These are the your common aims to manage any cancer patient. So what are the things you can do for any cancer patient? So your exercise always should be, while doing designing any exercise program for any cancer patient, you should always remain, you are always concerned about the frequency, intensity, time and type of the volume. So these are some of the factors where you should always concern while designing any exercise program for cancer patient. Just only I told you, always start with aerobic exercise only during the rehabilitation phase for any cancer patient. Then some of the, how you can manage fatigue, just only I told you, bed rest exercise, aerobic exercise, energy conservation technique, diversional activities, stress, nutritional, all things. Aerobic exercise are the best exercise for designing and for starting any cancer patient in rehabilitation phase. Only you have to concern some of the factors regarding the aerobic exercise. Your exercise should be, don't go more than 3 to 5 days per week. Always start from 3 days per week to the, go for the 5 days per week. Okay. It should be on the moderate speed. Don't go for the high speed. Okay. Time, don't start more than 75 minutes per week. Always start. If you are giving 5 sessions a week, just do 15 minutes per day only. Your progression also should be slower as compared to another one normal patient. Just remember all these things while designing the aerobic exercise program. But it's very good program for all the cancer patient, aerobic exercise. Rhythmic contraction, relaxation of large muscle group, you can go. Okay, it's very effective for all the cancer patient. Aerobic conditioning is generally performed in the repetitive fashion using large muscle group. First, they start with the large muscle group only. Start with the proximal muscle, then go for the distal muscle. Don't do in once more than 5 times for a particular muscle. Just remember all this. Follow with the exercise of the distal muscle. Start with the proximal and follow with the distal muscle. Swimming also one of the good exercise for all the cancer patients. Walking also, easy biking also, 20 to 30 minutes biking, very good exercise for yoga also, because combination of the stretching, deep breathing and relaxation techniques very good for positive impact on the venous and lymphatic drainage and all the cancer patients. It's very good exercise. Then level method also, new method only. What happened here? Focus on healing through the movement and dance. Very good method. When the level method, it's a therapeutic exercise program for women who has undergone the PCR related cases. It's very effective to manage the post surgical lymphedema. So movement through the dance or movement with the healing. So very good method for the rehabilitation of all the cancer patients. Yoga again, then Pilates exercise also, strengthening of the core muscle group. So it's a very good program during the rehabilitation phase for all the cancer. The resistive exercise also we can start. Only remember while starting the resistive exercise, always start with the warm up phase. Okay, jogging, sport, marching and all these things. Then you have to start for the major muscles first, upper limb and lower limb, like the biceps, triceps, the hand muscles and long flexors of the forearm. Then lower limb also again, hamstring, quadriceps and tendonitis. Start with, then don't go more than 5 days per week. Okay, always start again, yeah, same like the aerobic only, 3 days, then maximum you can go for the 5 days only. And when you can start the resistive exercise, after 6 weeks only. After 6 weeks of the surgery only. Sometimes you can start, you can take more time also, because by that time chemo and radio is going on. So everything depends on the condition of the patient only. Okay. So then again, repetition also, your repetition should be not more than one set. Okay. You always start with the one set only, and you are 8 to 10 repetition only in one set. Then progression again, after 2 weeks, you can go for the two sets. Okay. So again, 15 to 20 repetition only. Just remember all these things while designing the, always start with the lowest weight only, 1 to 2 pounds only. Don't go more than 1 to 2 pounds. Then breathing exercise also, relaxation techniques also very useful for all the cancer patients. Reduce the anxiety level, increase the energy level, improve the concentration, self-confidence. Okay, so very good. Firstly, breathing exercise also, very abdominal diaphragmatic breathing also. Okay, ACBT technique also, active cycle of breathing technique, very effective for all the cancer patients. Then strengthening exercise, just only I told you. Then neck exercise also, especially in the case of the head and neck cancer patient, some of the neck exercise you can go for that also. Tilting, turning, chin to chest exercise, just see all the SCM exercise for the sternocleidomastoid muscle, neck rotations, head tilts, just see the pictures. Repetitious exercise also, you can start for the head and neck cancer cases. Shoulder blade exercise, shrugging, upright row, push-ups. Then TMJ exercise also, especially in the cases of the oral cavity cancer and all this. Jaw exercises, tongue resistance, swell amplitude, gum chew, Valsova maneuver, and Mendelssohn maneuver, Muscova maneuver, all these exercises you can go for the TMJ joint cases, tongue resistance, just see how the patient will do, how you will teach the patient. Swollen amplitude, gum chew exercise, Mendelssohn maneuver, Muscova maneuver, goldfish exercise also, good exercise for the TMJ cases, just for mouth opening. Facial exercise also, lip closure, jaw and mouth movements, eye movements, smiling, frowning, facial expression, forehead wrinkling and all these things. You know these facial exercises you have to do for the bells and facial bells also. Then swallowing exercise also, shaker exercise, best exercise. High lift member also. And effort full swelling also. Supraglottic swelling also. Electrical stimulation sometimes very useful in all these cases. Oromotor therapy also sometimes useful. Laryngeal elevation also. Then postural techniques also. Sometimes positioning and postural techniques also very effective. Chin down and chin up exercise. Head rotation, head tilting for all the head and neck cases. Sometimes we need the prosthesis also in the rehabilitation phases. Sensory stimulation also very effective in some cases. The shoulder exercise also, you know, shoulder exercise also, shoulder shrugging, forward flexion, sideways flexion, rotation, abduction, adduction, chair rotation, stretching, revolve triangle, upward plank. Same thing, you can go for the lower limb and others also. Just see shoulder exercise. Some of the picture again, for shoulder exercise. Arm exercise also. Same thing for elbow also. Elbow flexion, extension and all these things. Lot of exercise is there. Then Theraband, very good Theraband exercise is very good for the all the cancer patient. Why? Because lot of advantage is there with the Theraband. Easy to carry, very easy to purchase, available in lot of colors and sizes. So I am always supporting the Theraband exercise for all the cancer patients. So while discharging from our clinic or when we'll treat the patient in group exercise, always go for the Theraband exercise for the cancer patient. Just see here how you can do Theraband exercise for the cancer patient. For upper limb and lower limb. Okay. Now I will show you some of the, I will start this and I will show some of the pictures for the bandaging and all these things. I will show you the parts of the bandaging system. Let's see here. MLLB, just only I told you, multilayer lymphedema bandaging. So this type of bandages we have to use in MLLB. So these are the finger bandages we are using in MLLB. Then tubular bandages available in lot of size. For upper limb, we have to go with the minimal size 4, then 6, 8, and 12. Then extra bandings also we have to apply for the uneven surfaces. Just only told you. And stoking also, we have to apply stoking before doing the bandaging for the lymphedema cases for the upper limb and lower limb. Remember this thing. Lot of type of the compression devices also available in the market. It depends on the types and knitting technique. So how much it is costly. So a lot of type of the compression device also available in the market. Just see here. All the upper limb and lower limb. Lot of type of compression devices are available. Just see here. Then MLG also we are doing with the help of this type of the special soft ball just to clear the lymphatics. Okay. So all these things I will show you in the practical. Today I will just brief little bit regarding the cancer rehabilitation. What is the cancer? So just only I told you complementary medicine technique. Lot of techniques are there. MLLB, MLD, lymphedema taping. So all the sometimes the instrument associated soft tissue mobilization is also very effective in the cases of the third degree lymphedema and all these things. If the fibrosis will develop, so all the things will come in practical class only. So already one of so Saurabh ji, if somebody want to ask something, just tell them to. Hello.
Okay, sir. Yeah, okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Dr. Saurabh, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please read out the questions. No?
Yes, sir. In which cases TMJ exercises are needed?
Especially in the cases of the oral surgery cases where there are a lot of type of the oral cavity carcinomas are there. There the patient has to go for some of the oral surgeries. Definitely there TMJ joint rehabilitation needed. Especially in the disorder of the TMJ joint. It's a very common carcinoma in TMJ joint and oral cavity here. Especially in the tobacco chewing cases.
Okay. Sir, can you tell about this energy conservation technique?
Energy conservation technique, because in all the cancer patients during the rehabilitation phase, their fatigueness is a very common complication. Their energy level is very low as compared to normal patient. So we have to go for the diversional activities. If they cannot do any work in one short or regularly, so we have to divide the work in small steps. Okay. So like that, we can conserve their energy and they can do their ADL activities also and their vocational activities also. It's a very important technique in rehabilitation phase because their psychological factor is also there and a patient is not having the energy level to complete all the tasks within a short or within a same period. So we have to divide the activity in small steps. Or sometimes we have to design some diversional pattern also just to perform any specific activity.
Which cancer, which stage of the cancer is totally curable? That is the question, sir.
Mostly in our country, most of the cases are diagnosed in the second stage only. So 99% cases needs surgery only, sometimes without surgery also by the chemo and radio also. But we cannot say like that if the patients will come in the primary stage. So survival rate is around 60 to 70%. Okay, but the patient, if they will come in the secondary stage only, the survival rate is around 20 to 30%.
Sir, what should be the...
When the patient will diagnose with the cancer? Because here we are lacking, every time I am telling, we are lacking in the screening program. We don't have any screening protocols here for all the types of cancer. So most of the patient will come, will go to the doctor when the symptom will come. They will not go as a routine examination after each year for the medical screening and all these things. So most of the patient will go to the doctor after development of the symptom only.
How should be the approach in pediatric oncology?
Pediatric oncology, some of the cancer always related with the malnutrition and all these things only, because it is also one of the factor I told you in etiology also. So the children's, those are lacking some special type of the nutrition, their weak nutritional status and some type of the hereditary condition, they are more prone for development of all these cases. So this type of the group is always considered as the high risk group. So early diagnosis and early treatment is always necessary in the high risk group. They have to go for the routine examination, high risk group especially. So this type of children we can diagnose in the early stage only. Mostly for the children, all the disorder related with the hereditary, either hereditary or nutritional symptom only.
Sir, what is the meaning of diversional approach?
Diversional approach means we have to divide from mool pathway. We have to design some new technique just to conserve the energy. That is called as the diversion. Suppose your patient is related with one of the specific activities, some vocational activities. So if he is some special type of the worker, he will do in the rehabilitation phase, again he has to go for the again, because he is the member of the family, he has to go for the earning, he has to go for the work, he has to go for office, factory, everywhere, whatever he is doing before the treatment also. So for that particular task, if he's expending more energy, how you can design the task in new ways so he can save the energy and he can do for the without losing more energy for the more time. So that is your rehabilitation for just to diverse the activity. And same thing for the ADL also. Some cases are not able to do their ADL activities voluntary or individually because of some lot of loss of the energy and because of some of the deformities or some of the so many things are some of the so, so in some surgeries the surgeon has to cut some of the part also. So there, how you can design their ADL activities in better way by preventing the energy status, so they can go for their activity.
What is the kinesiology taping technique for such kind of
issues? You know, kinesiological taping we are using for the neurological cases also, orthopedic cases also. So here also very effective. By that kinesiological tape, if we will fix on the affected part, so it will fix the upper layer of the skin. So it will end putting the more pressure in the deeper layer, and it will enhance the circulation for the lymphatic and venous in the deeper layer. So definitely some of the edema will remove from there. So it's very useful. Only the thing, you should place directly on the body affected body part only, and you should place in the fan-like pattern. So one end is the always broad, and another end is always narrow, and you have to just put on this like a sling-like strip pattern on the affected part. Remember this thing. If your placement is proper, definitely it will helpful for removing the edema on that particular side.
So there is a question about a 7-year female baby undergone rotosinoplasty because of Ewing sarcoma. What should be the approach for such kind of patient, Ewing sarcoma?
What is the condition of children right now? What are the main complications right now?
Okay, that is not specified in the question. I would request the participant who asked the question can unmute and ask verbally to sir. Okay, I think he's not connected or he's not connected. Okay, how the facial exercises are useful? There's the last question.
Facial exercise, sir, you know, na, facial, lot of types of the carcinoma related with the head and neck only. So definitely whenever your range of motion will affect it, either for the oral cavity, TMJ joint or any, because whenever the face will involve or neck will involve or your jaw will involve, definitely some of the secondary factor will affect it, the range of motion for all the joints and muscles also. So here, if we do the facial exercise, the face symmetry will come on the normal stage only, and there are no more another complication related with the osmotic appearance, and so many things are there. So range of motion also we have to maintain it to all the facial joints, like especially for the oral cavity. So facial exercise is always important here, mostly for the cosmetic purpose as well as for the range of motion purpose.
Patient is not able to dorsiflex. About the Ewing sarcoma case I was referring, 7 years female, not able to dorsiflex.
Please unmute, sir. Please unmute yourself.
Patient is able to do another movement for the lower limb.
Yes, sir.
Only dorsiflexion patient is not able to do.
So dorsiflexion is now basically her knee flexion. So we can say she is not able to flex the knee because her ankle joint is functioning as her knee joint.
Oh, no, pardon, I didn't get what you want to say. Patient is not able to do knee flexion.
Sir, her distal part of the leg has been connected with the thigh, so, and has been rotated 180 degrees. That is the rotation plasty, the surgery that has been done. So now the dorsiflexion is basically her knee flexion because the ankle joint is functioning as her knee joint. And
so ankle joint is free or there is stiffness in ankle joint?
The range is full. The passive range of motion is full, but actively the patient is not able to dorsiflex.
Active range of motion is not there.
Passive is full, active is not.
Then no problem. If passive range is full, then you can go for the lot of physio techniques. So definitely it will come.
Sir, can you please suggest?
If the doctor will permit, just check the patient condition. You can use the electric stimulation also in some of the cases.
Sir, because there is an implant inside, will electrical stimulation be safe?
Just place the electrode on some another place.
Okay. And sir, will taping help?
No, in this step, it depends on the joint condition. That's why I'm asking. If ankle joint is free, no stiffness is there, you can go for taping also.
Sir, taping as to what kind of technique can we...
You just do one thing, just position the ankle for some time in the some particular position where you can enhance the movement of the dorsiflexors. this type of taking you can do, like the ortho cases only. Neurological cases, what you will do in neurological stroke cases, you tell me. If you want to facilitate some particular movement, how you will do the taping for the neurological cases? Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Basically, we'll try to increase that range which we want to gain.
Same like if you will just treat any stroke or any neurological cases with the taping, just you want to facilitate any movement. So the same thing you can go here also with the taping. If joint range of motion is the free, it depends on the ankle range of motion. If any stiffness is there, you cannot go for the taping.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Then go for the PNF also. It is also very useful. If joint range of motion is free there, just go for the PNF also. It is also very useful in all these cases.
Professor, please unmute and ask your doubts.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
There is a question called deep oscillation therapy. How does it help in rehabilitation?
Sir, deep oscillation therapy, I have never used and in all these lymphedema cases because I think it's not useful here. I have never tried deep oscillation
therapy. Okay. Okay. Thank you so much, sir. It was an amazing interaction with all the participants. And
anything else anybody want to ask?
Can unmute and ask, please, participants. Sir is taking your questions.
Hi, sir. Good morning.
Vibrator. Don't use massage vibrator in all the cancer cases. Okay. Whatever you want to do, just do by your hands only. Okay.
Sir, good morning, sir. How can we prevent the aspiration pneumonia, which where we cannot find the swallowing, where we patients with the feeling with the swallowing difficulties.
Hello? Pardon?
Aspiration pneumonia, sir.
Repeat the question.
How can we prevent the aspiration pneumonia?
Sir, question is like, how can we prevent the aspirational pneumonia?
Aspiration pneumonia. So, it's where it will mainly occur, especially in the children's cases. Okay. Aspiration pneumonia and all these things. So for that initial phase only you have to start with the breathing exercise. But once if the pneumonia will develop, don't go for the breathing exercise. Remember this thing. Once the pneumonia will develop, don't go for the breathing exercise. Before development of the pneumonia, if you want to prevent from development of the pneumonia, you can go for the breathing exercise.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, how can we manage genital lymphedema in females?
Genital lymphedema always depends on the family history. Genital lymphedema is not like the children's mostly you will get. What do you mean
by? Like in the cervical cancer cases and all, sometimes the lymphedema is there along with the lower limb lymphedema.
Cervical lymphedema, listen. Cervical cancer and all these cases, lymphedema is not a genital lymphedema. Just remember, when cervical cancer will come in the picture, if you are taking about the elder females, so mostly after the 40 years or 45 years only. So it's not a genital lymphedema. It's because of the surgery and after the surgery because of some another secondary reason. Okay.
Yes.
Genital lymphedema, mostly the cases will come in their childhood only. Just remember this thing. So that is because of some family region or some of the abnormality of the lymphatic system. But the genital lymphedema, if it will come after the cervical surgery or any uterine surgery or any endometrial surgery or any gynecological surgery, it is because of the surgery only. It is always secondary.
How can we manage that, sir?
Sir, lymphedema, like just only I told you, a lot of management protocols, some of the complementary medicine also, elevation exercises, then MLD also we can do, MLLB also, tapping therapy also we can use. Lot of techniques are there.
Okay.
Some of the compression devices also we can use. Then one of the very simple machine, you know, I think if you are working in the any cancer rehabilitation center or any cancer specialty hospital, very simple machine, you know, that also. Who will tell me regarding that machine?
Pardon, sir, which machine?
if somebody is working in any cancer hospital or any cancer clinics, very simple equipment is there. Can you tell me the name of that equipment? Just to facilitate the lymphedema drainage, very simple machine is there everywhere.
The pneumatic compression device?
Yeah, pneumatic compression device. Everywhere it's available. Okay.
Yeah.
Decompression therapy. Somebody asked me regarding decompression therapy. Bandaging system also part of the decompression therapy only. Pneumatic compression device also part of the decompression therapy only. And some of the elastic garments and all the elastic compression devices, they are also part of the decompression therapy only.
Okay. It was a really good interaction, sir. Thank you, participants, for asking your questions. So, would like to inform every participant that in Bangalore we are having the search 2 days event by Dr. Shailendra Mehta, January 9th and January 10th. Yeah, the flyer is on the this one, and then all members will get the discounts and all. Then you can just call on the numbers given in the flyer, and the flyer will be given to this group also. It will be posted by WhatsApp, so you can just join him. And you can learn completely about the lymphedema management. Sir has extensive experience and in both the terms, in academics as well as the clinical. So that is how it will be. See you, sir.
Yes. Practical, yeah. We'll discuss either in the next class or when we'll meet for the workshop physically. Practical also, because a lot of complementary medicine techniques are there that I can explain in practical classes only, like MLLB, MLD and tapping. So, because here also different patterns are there for upper limb, head and neck and lower limb, trunk. Everywhere different pattern is there for tapping also, MLLB also and MLD also. So that I will show you in the some workshop or practical class only or some another time. But it's a very good field. Definitely, we will work in the cancer rehabilitation field. A lot of opportunities there. Once if you are mounted with 100 patients, no need to do anything. Because lifetime recurrence chances is there. So patient will always engage the patient himself in the some preventive measures only. Because recurrence chance every after 10 years also, after 20 years also. So once if somebody is developed with the cancer, a lot of complication is also there. Even after the chemo radio, after 3 to 4 years also. So patient is always engaged himself with the exercises only. So it's a good field to do work for the cancer rehabilitation. So you just do work in cancer only. It's very good.
Okay. So I always say that nurses and physical therapists are never going to over, no matter how much AI comes. So they are always important for the patient. Dear participants, your code will be appear on the in the setting screen. You can just see that. This particular code you can send to 9066.
Somebody is asking regarding esophageal cancer. Okay. So I told you in my presentation, lot of swelling maneuver is there. Okay, TMJ swelling maneuver. So you just go for that for esophageal cancer. Mendelssohn maneuver, Moskova maneuver. So many things I told you. It's very helpful for esophageal patient.
So okay. The code you can message my rehab to 9066990059 and you will get the link for the certificate. Again, I remind every one of you, you can join search direct class on 9th and 10th January in Bangalore. There you can learn a lot about practical parts, which is critical to this field. Our whole team will be supporting you in right from booking to feedback.
Dr. Saurabh, this code is active till like any time limit is there.
Somebody yeah. Asking me
this code will be active only till 12 o'clock today, 12 o'clock daytime.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Somebody is asking me how race and nationality is related with the prostate cancer. Why I told you nationality here? Because it's very common cancer for the Americans. Okay, that's why I told you in etiology it's related to the nationality also. Because they are African Americans especially, they are more prone for development of prostate cancer one out of three men, they will develop the prostate cancer in their lifetime, especially in the African Americans. That's why, and Rashid also here, same thing. Some of the heredity factor is also responsible for development of the prostate cancer in African Americans. Lot of organization and NGOs are working in the field of cancer rehabilitation. Somebody is asking regarding the financial aid by the, you know, some like so many charitable trusts also working in the field of the providing the financial support only for the cancer patients. So you can apply there. Lot of charitable trusts are there, even in Delhi, Bombay, metro cities. Just they will provide the financial aid. Lot of NGOs also are there. You can go to Tata Memorial Hospital, Bombay. Okay, they are there. Lot of NGOs are working in collaboration with the TMC only. They will provide the financial support also and the rehabilitation support also. They will provide some of the prosthesis, orthosis also for the cancer patient.
I hope most of the query have been answered. I think 99% have been answered.
Sai Ram, what Sai Ram want to
what
ask?
What is the question?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, see you, sir. We'll wind up. I think everybody has copied the code.
Okay, sir. We'll wind up, sir. With your permission.
Yeah, with your permission, can we wind up?
Okay.
Thank you so much, all the participants. Thank you, Dr. Diwakar. Thank you, CEO, sir. And of course, it was never possible. Like